What's up, everyone? Welcome back to Ask Our Experts. I'm your host, Ulysses, and today we are going to explore more functionalities of midspans. I understand at the beginning, when there were no PoE switches, that midspans or injectors were needed. However, today there are many PoE switches available on the market. Alan, why would anyone need a midspan, also known as an injector, today?
Ulysses, I get this question all the time. Today, PoE switches are available. You can buy them any place. But of the installed networks, only 20% of the installed networks actually provide power. So if you are deploying over an existing network that does not have power, you are still going to need a midspan to supplement and provide that power. And 50% of the switches today do have power. They are PoE switches, but 50% don't. So you still might need a midspan. But here's the real thing. Even if a switch can provide power, it might not be able to provide power on every port. Every switch comes with something called a power budget, and a portion of that power budget is consumed by the switch to make it operate. The rest of the power is available to be distributed on the ports, but there is usually not enough power to give full power on all the ports. So even if you have a PoE switch, you might still need a midspan to supplement on those ports that cannot provide full power.
Thanks, Alan. Now I understand that midspans play an important role in powering PoE devices, even in today's environment where PoE switches are available. Viewers, to learn more about midspans and their functionalities, check out our helpful links in the description below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.